हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। सी, वेलकम बैक टू अवर ई लर्निंग सेशन एंड दिस इज योर सेवेंथ लेक्चर ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 5। ओके, सी हियर, इन अवर लास्ट सेशन वी कंप्लीट अवर कार्ल पियर्सन मेथड ऑफ स्क्यूनेस एज वेल एज कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ स्क्यूनेस, दैट इज एक्सरसाइज 5.1। एंड हियर आई टोल्ड यू दैट यू हैव टू डू एक्सरसाइज 5 सेक्शन ए बी सी इन योर होमवर्क इन द फेयर बुक। ओके, आई होप यू कंप्लीट दैट। सी नाउ, वी विल स्टार्ट नाउ इन दिस सेशन न्यू मेथड, दैट इज बाउलीज मेथड ऑफ स्क्यूनेस एज वेल एज कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ स्क्यूनेस। सी, आई एम रीडिंग फर्स्ट। प्रोफेसर ए एल बाउली हैज गिवन अ मेजर ऑफ स्क्यूनेस बेस्ड ऑन क्वार्टाइल। सी, कार्ल पियर्सन मेथड इज बेस्ड ऑन विच mean, mode, standard deviation if mode is defined, and mean, median and standard deviation if mode is ill-defined. See, this is based on the measures of central tendency. Now, this one, the Bowley's method is based on positional average, that is quartiles Q1, Q2 and Q3. Q1, Q3 is the quartiles, but Q2 is again a median. So you can say Q1, median and the Q3 you have to find out, and you can find out the skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness in the Bowley's method. Okay, this measure is based on the positional of the position of the quartiles. It considers the main assumption that both the quartiles, that is Q1 and Q3, are not equidistant from the median, that is M or Q2, in a skewed frequency distribution. See, if the frequency distribution is symmetric, that is of bell shape, right? In the middle, median is there, and Q1 and Q3 are in the equal distance of the median. Okay, but whenever the distribution is skewed, that means here, the distance between between first quartile and median, or the third quartile and median, is not equal. So here the word, I again repeat that both the quartiles Q1 and Q3 are not equidistant the median in the skewed frequency distribution. That means the distance between Q1 and median, or Q3 and median, is not equal. Okay. The absolute measure of skewness, SK, is obtained using the quartile difference, that is Q3 minus M and M minus Q1. Okay, so here, the Bowley's method skewness SK is equal to Q3 minus M minus M minus Q1. This is the skewness. This is the formula, right? And now see that the skewness SK is equal to Q3 minus M and minus M minus Q1. Therefore, SK is equal to, now the original formula, this is the formula, but here this formula is used in rare case where the Q3 minus M and M minus Q1, both the values are directly given into the question. At that time only you can use this formula. Otherwise, the main formula, therefore you can say SK, skewness is equal to Q3 minus minus plus, so Q3 plus Q1, and M minus M minus M minus M, that is minus 2M. See again, Q3 minus minus plus, that's why Q3 plus Q1, minus M minus M minus minus plus, but sign of the highest value, that is minus. So minus 2m here, that this is the main formula for the skewness. This is the main formula for the skewness in the Bowley's method. This is also a formula of skewness, but it is only used when the two measures, that is two difference, Q3 minus M and M minus Q1 directly given into the question. In the short question, the values of this difference is given. We just have to use this formula. Otherwise, whenever we have to find out quartiles into the question, that is 5 marks long sum, whenever you have to find out the quartiles, median, all these things from the given data, you have to use this formula for the skewness. Okay, see here, we have studied two types of skewness. Now, the characteristics, or you can say properties, of the Bowley's method of skewness. Positive skewness negative skewness and the third one is symmetry distribution. First point, we have studied two types of skewness. We know that if the frequency distribution is a positive skewness, that here if we want the positive skewness, here if it is the difference between these two is higher than the difference of these two, then you can get the positive skewness. That means here the property is that Q3 minus M is greater than M minus Q1. Q3 minus M is greater than M minus Q1. Or you can say, on the basis of this, Q3 plus Q1 greater than 2M. Here, this is the first property of positive skewness. What is that? Q3 plus Q1 greater than 2M. This is the first property for the positive skewness. Whenever, or you can say here, whenever this data is given, then you can say SK is positive, or you can say SK greater than 0. Okay? Whenever the difference between quartile, third quartile and median is higher than or greater than the difference between median and Q1, that means here this is the positive skewness. Okay, now see here, we have the studied two types of skewness. We know that if the frequency distribution is a positive skewness, Q3 minus M greater than M minus Q1, therefore Q3 plus Q1 greater than 2M and S4 greater than SK greater than 0. For the negative skewness, now here, what is the properties for negative skewness? Now it is less than, you can say Q3 plus Q1 less than 2M. If the difference between these two, here difference between these two is less than these two, that means here your answer is negative, and that's why you can say Q3 plus Q1 total of these two is also less than 2M. That is, you can say here it is a negative skewness. Okay, on the basis of this is the properties of positive, negative as well as symmetric distribution from Bowley's method. Okay, for the frequency distribution is symmetric, here we have equal, this is equal to this, you can say Q3 minus M is equal to M minus Q1, the difference are equal, so at that point the distribution is symmetric. Okay, so you can say therefore Q3 Q3 plus Q1 is equal to 2m. These are the properties of positive, negative, symmetric distribution. These are the properties of Pauli's method, skewness. Okay? See, if the frequency distribution is a symmetry, we have Q3 minus m is equal to m minus Q1. Therefore, Q3 plus Q1 is equal to 2m, and standard skewness is equal to 0. The distance of Q1 and Q3 from the median, that is m, are m minus q1 and q3 minus m respectively. When the difference between these two values is divided by their sums, we obtain the relative measures of skewness, that is coefficient of skewness. Okay, thus Pauli's formula for coefficient of skewness. Now the new formula, properties is over. Now coefficient of skewness, that is J. What they say? Difference divided by sums. Q3 minus M minus M minus Q1. This is your skewness. Divided by Q3 minus M plus, their sum means not the difference. Difference here you have to take Q3 minus M as it is, but you have to take sum of these two difference, M minus Q1. This is the formula for J, coefficient of skewness. Okay, but here this is also this type of formula. We have to use this formula only in the rare cases. Why? Because whenever the difference is directly given into the question, at that time only we have to use this formula. Otherwise, we have to take this formula, and for this, therefore, J is equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2M. Q3 minus minus plus Q1 minus 2M divided by, see, Q3 minus Q1, because minus M plus M is cancelled here. Minus M plus M, here it is cancelled. That's why you can say Q3 minus Q1. So this is the main formula for coefficient of skewness, and this is the main formula for skewness under the Pauli's method. So first of all, write down this. I am reading that. Thus, Pauli's formula for coefficient of skewness J is as follows. J is equal to Q3 minus M minus M minus Q1 upon Q3 minus M plus M minus Q1. Or you can say Q3 plus Q1 minus 2M divided by Q3 minus Q1. See, in the statistics, formula is most important, because these full statistics, not only in 11th but also in 12th, all this subject, statistics full subjects, is fully based on the formula. If you know the formula, then and then you can get the marks, or then and then you can get the sum. Okay, otherwise, if you don't know the formula, then if you know the calculation also, but if you don't know the formula, you cannot complete, you cannot solve the sum. Okay, so here these formulas is also based on, this chapter is also based on chapter number 3 and 4, measures of central tendency and measures of dispersal. So here you have to do these, all this formula, you have to learn all this formula, otherwise you cannot solve these sums. So first of all, write down these. I'm reading that. The measures of skewness obtained by the by this formula is called Pauli's coefficient of skewness. We know that the values of Q3 minus M and M minus Q1 are positive, the difference between the two any two real numbers is less than or equal to their sum. Difference between the any two numbers real number is less than or equal to 1. Okay, equal to their sum. Thus, here you can say Q3 minus M minus Q1 divided by Q3 minus M plus M minus Q1 in a modulus is less than or equal to 1. Always the value of coefficient of skewness is between minus 0 to plus minus 1 to plus 1. Okay, so here the next property I'm writing here, J, modulus J is less than or equal to 1. Modulus J means this formula in a modulus form, and the answer is less than or equal to 1, or you can say in a different way, minus 1 less than or equal to J less than or equal to 1. This is the next property. Always the value of coefficient of skewness on Bowley's method is between minus 1 to plus 1. See, I told you when we when we do the Carl Pearson's method, at that time I told you that properties of Carl Pearson method, value when the mode is defined, when in the Carl Pearson method, when mode is defined, the values of J, that is coefficient of skewness, is between minus 1 to plus 1. This, just like this, when mode is defined. And in the Carl Pearson method, value of coefficient of skewness is just like this, because minus 1 less than or equal to J less than or equal to 1. So you can say the value of J is minus between minus 1 to plus 1. Not more than 1 and not less than minus 1. Okay? But whenever the mode is ill-defined, I told you at that time when mode is ill-defined. So here at that time we are using the formula of median to find out the skewness or coefficient of skewness. At that time, the value of J, that is coefficient of skewness, is between minus 3 to plus 3. Okay, so here you can say minus 3 less than or equal to J less than or equal to 3. That is the range of J of coefficient of skewness when mode is ill-defined in Carl Pearson method. But in the Bowley's method and in the Carl Pearson method, whenever the mode is defined, the value is between minus 1 to plus 1 of coefficient of skewness. Therefore, modulus Bowley's coefficient of skewness J, modulus over less than or equal to 1. Therefore, you can say minus 1 less than or equal to J less than or equal to 1. This is the main property of Bowley's method. Okay. Thus, the range of the Bowley's coefficient of skewness is minus 1 to plus 1. If your answer is more than 1.5, 1.8, 2.5 in J, in Bowley's method, that means your answer is wrong. You have made some mistakes in the question or in the answer. So please remember that always value of J is between minus 1 to plus 1 in the Bowley's method. Okay, now note, most important note is given, in which situation you have to use the Bowley's method. It is given in the note. If the question not specifically says that which method you have to use in these sums, then only says that find out skewness or coefficient of skewness by appropriate method, then you have to use which formula. The specification regarding this is given into the note. Please reading, I am reading that note. Note number 1. If the frequency distribution is open-ended. Open-ended means what? Less than 0, less than 10, less than 20, less than 30, less than 40. This type of data, this is called open-ended data. This type of data, whenever given, you can say you don't use the Carl Pearson method. You have to use the Bowley's method, because less than or more than distribution is given at that time you cannot find out. We already discussed about that in our fourth chapter, that is measurement of dispersion. In the standard deviation topic we already discussed about that. Whenever this data is given, less than or more than data is given, then you cannot find out the mid value. On the basis of that you cannot find out the mean, and on the basis of that you cannot find out the standard deviation. So if you cannot find out the mean and standard deviation, you cannot use the Karl-Pearson method, because in the Karl-Pearson method, if mode is defined or ill-defined, both mean and standard deviation is compulsory, it's required, right? So whenever it is not defined, that means mean and standard deviation we cannot find out, then at that time we have to use this formula, that is Bowley's method. So in short, whenever the data is open-ended, or you can say less than or more than data distribution is given, at that time you have to use the Bowley's method or use the to find out skewness or coefficient of skewness. Okay, if the frequency distribution is open-ended, this is only method, that is Bowley's method, to find out the absolute and relative measures of skewness, that is skewness and coefficient of skewness. And the second note, second point is, Bowley's method is appropriate when the skewness is to be found using the positional average. In the question, it is specifically says that you have to find out the skewness as well as coefficient of skewness by using positional average. Which one is the positional average? If you know, in the chapter number 3, it is specifically said that positional average means quartile, decile, percentile or median. First median, then quartile, decile, percentile, all are called positional averages. And in the question directly said that you have to find out skewness as well as coefficient of skewness by positional averages, then it means you have to find out by quartiles. So quartiles Q1, Q3 and Q2, that is median, you have to find out by Bowley's method indirectly. Okay, so Bowley's method is appropriate when the skewness is to be found using the positional averages, which are quartiles and median. Okay, so first of all, here I am giving you 1 or 2 minutes for that. Please read all these properties, all these notes, important point, and please write down these note also in your fair book. First of all, write down these formulas, then write down these two notes in your fair book, and then we will discuss about our next illustration. Okay, so first of all, write down that. I'm giving you here 1 or 2 minutes for that. Write down these formulas and then two notes. Most important two notes. This is also important property. Please write down these also. I hope you complete these. Now please write down the notes. Note number 1 and note number 2. I am removing here this one. Okay, I hope you complete the notes. Now see illustration number 12. The data about the rainfall in centimeter at a place in a month during the monsoon are obtained as follows. Find the skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness using Bowley's method. Here specifically saying that you have to use Bowley's method. That means quartile, median and quartile and medians. Q1 median and Q3 you have to find out, and on the basis of that you have to find out skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness. So here rainfall in centimeter is given first, then number of days is also given. But in this case the main thing you have to concentrate that here the data is not given in an order. See, if you remember that whenever we are finding out median of ungrouped data, quartiles of ungrouped data, we first arrange the data in ascending order and then we find out the median, quartiles. Okay, here again this is which type of data is given. Here it is an discrete group data is given, but it is not also given in an ascending order, not in any order. Six, first of all x value of x, that is rainfall in centimeter, is given, that is 6, then 7, then 13, then 5. Okay, so here not in order. So first of all we have to arrange the data compulsory in an ascending order. So x, that is your all observations, we have to arrange in an ascending order. So first one is 5, then 6, then 7, then 13, then 15 and 20. Now frequency, that is number of days, you can write 10, 5, 3, 8, 3, 2, yes, no. Here if we are changing the data, that is original data, that is here x, if we are changing x order, then we have to also change the frequency order. That means not here frequency we don't have to write down in ascending order, we just have to write down the corresponding frequency. That means what? We just have to arrange the data of x, that means all the observations we have to just arrange, we don't have to arrange the frequency, we have to write the frequency corresponding to the observation. 5, frequency is what? That is 8. Frequency of 5 is 8. We have to write down that first. Frequency of 6 is 10. We have to write down then. Then frequency of 7 is equal to 5. So corresponding frequency we have to write. We just have to arrange the x, that is all the observations we have to arrange in an ascending order, and then write down the corresponding frequency on the frequency column. Then 13, 3, 15, 3 and 2. Now what we have to find out? To find out the quartiles as well as median. See, if we want to find out mean, if we want to find out standard deviation, then we have to prepare mean values column D, that is shortcut xi minus a, fd, fd square, all this column we have to prepare in the Carl Pearson's method. But here we just have to find out the quartiles q1, q2 and q3. So here we need only one column, that is cf, cumulative frequency. CF. Make the total first 8 plus 10, 18 plus 5, 23 plus 3, 26 plus 3, 29 and plus 2,
31. So your n is equal to 31. Okay, very easy. Now what we need? Q1, Q2 and Q3, that is quartile, median, quartile 1, Q1, median and Q3. And on the basis of that, we have to find out skewness as well as coefficient of skewness by using Dowdy's method. Now Q1, what is the formula? N plus 1 by 4th observation. That is the formula for that. N is equal to 31. Eighth observation, and eighth observation we have to see in the cumulative frequency column, and the corresponding observation is 5. So you can say therefore Q1 is equal to 5 centimeter. This is your first answer. Now find out Q2, that is median. N plus 1 by 2th observation. So here 31 plus 1 by 2 observation. So 32 by 2 observation. Here it is 16th observation. And 16, we have to see in the cumulative frequency column, 16 is lies between 8 and 18. So again, the corresponding observation is median is equal to 8 centimeter. Here Q1, median is there. Now Q3. N plus 1 by 4, but here 3 observation. So you can say 3, 31 plus 1 by 4th observation, that is 3, 32 by 4th observation, 8 threes are 24th observation, and C in the cumulative frequency column, it lies between 23 to 26. So here in the 26, the corresponding observation is, therefore you can say Q3 is equal to 13 centimeter. So all the three values, all the three quartiles is here. Now we just have to find out skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness. Skewness is equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2m is equal to, Q3 is equal to what? 13 plus 5 minus 2 into 8 is equal to 18 minus, sorry, here 6 is the answer, 6 centimeter. You have to write down 6 here, 6 twos are 12. So the final answer of skewness is 6 cm. Skewness is equal to 6 cm. Okay? SK is equal to 6 cm. This is your final answer of skewness. Now, coefficient of skewness. That is J. Formula for this, Q3 plus Q1 minus 2M divided by Q3 minus Q1. Q3 is equal to 13 plus 5 minus 2 into 6 divided by 13 minus 5, that is 18 minus 12 divided by 8. Six divided by 8, three by 4, so you can say 0.75. So your value of J, therefore you can say J is equal to 0.75 is the final answer. See here, skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness is here. Skewness is equal to 6 cm and here again the answer is between minus 1 to 1. So you can say your answer is correct. Here you have to write down centimeter, but here in the J, that is coefficient of skewness, you don't have to write down any measure. So your J is equal to directly 0.75. So write down this first sum. I hope you complete that. Now see the illustration number 13 and illustration number 14 is very big sum. Right now here, that is, see here it is a continuous group data, or you can say less than more than data. That's sum, that two sum we will discuss in our next session, but right now we are doing illustration number 15. See, I told you whenever in the special cases when the difference between the two measurement, that is quartile and median and median and quartile, that is Q3 minus M and M minus Q1 is directly given into the question, we don't have to use this formula for skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness. But in that case also, if the value of only quartile directly given the value of Q1, M and Q3, at that point we have to use this formula. See, the difference is directly given, we have to use the first formula. But if the values of Q1, median and Q3 is given, then just put the value here and find out these and these also. Okay, so if the values of these three is given, we don't have to write down these, we don't have to find out these. We just given this and this is the short sum. We just have to find out these two, that is skewness as well as coefficient of skewness, by putting the values of Q1, Q2 and Q3 into the formula. And that's why we are doing that particular illustration number 15 right now. Okay, so I am reading that illustration number 15. See, for a frequency distribution of a monthly overtime in hours of the employees of a company, the difference between the two
extreme quartiles, two extreme quartiles, that is what? Q1 and Q3. And difference between these two is given is 50. And their sum, that is difference Q3 minus Q1 is equal to 50. And their sum, that is Q3 plus Q1 is equal to 218. If the median is 112, then find out the coefficient of skewness. See, illustration number 15. The data is not given in a direct form. We have to first find out the values and then put the values into the formula. What information is given? See the style of the question again. In the statistics only, the style of the question is changed. You have to know about what they want to say or what they want to give on into the data, and from the given data, you have to find out the skewness as well as the coefficient of skewness or the measurement which asked into the question. Always the different style of the question is here. 15. Difference between two extreme quartiles that is Q3 minus Q1 is equal to 50 and sum of two extreme quartiles is equal to Q3 plus Q1 and it is given 218, and the median, that is M, is equal to 112. These three information is given into the question, and on the basis of that you have to find out SK, that is skewness, and J, that is coefficient of skewness. Okay, so first of all, if the regular formula we are using, what is the formula for skewness? Q3 plus Q1 minus 2M divided by Q3 minus Q1. Q3 plus Q1 given? Yes, it is 218. Q3 minus Q1 is given? Yes, it is 50. Q3 plus Q1, 280. Q3 minus Q1, 50. M is given? Yes, 112. So just put the value into the question. All the values we have, but the style of the question is changed here. The difference between two quartiles, the wording, in the wording it is given. See, up to this all the values is given, Q3, Q1 and M is given directly into the sum. But now in this sum, the data is given in a theoretical form. Right? See the word again. I am reading that. Employees of the company, the difference between the two extreme quartiles, difference between two extreme quartiles, that is Q3 minus Q1 is 50, and their sum, that is sum of two extreme quartiles, that is Q3 plus Q1 is equal to 218, and median is equal to 112. So here just put the value. Now if you know this, then you will get the answer. If you don't know these two only, on the from this data, then you cannot get the answer. 218 minus 2 into bracket m is equal to 112 divided by q3 minus q1, that is 50, is equal to, see, 218 minus 224 divided by 50. So minus 6 divided by 50 minus 0.12. Sorry, this is not a formula for skewness. This is the formula for coefficient of skewness. Is equal to J, and J is equal to, right now the answer is J is equal to minus 0.12. Okay, so here very easy sum, just put the value given into the question in the formula and find out the answer, simplify it and find out the answer. But if you don't know this, on the basis of this given two information in theoretical form, then you cannot get the answer, you cannot get 2 marks, because this is a 2 mark sum. So first of all, please write down this. Complete? Okay. Now, first write down this. If you don't, I am reading the question. Illustration number 16. Next, short sum again. Mode of symmetric frequency distribution is 84. See the word, underline the particular word. Symmetric distribution. Okay. Mode of symmetric frequency distribution, unlike symmetric frequency distribution, this is the important word for this sum. Okay, mode is equal to 84. If the first quartile is 68, find the third quartile. Mode is 84. First quartile, third quartile, we have to, first quartile is given, third quartile we have to find out, but median is not given, mode is given. Mode is not used in Pauli's method. In Pauli's method, see the sum of Pauli's method we are doing right now, right? Quartile 1 is given, that is okay. Quartile 3, q3 we have to find out, that is okay. That is under the Pauli's method. But here the strange is that mode is given. Why? See the main thing. Illustration number 16. Underline the word symmetric. Frequency distribution the main line of this question is symmetric frequency distribution, and the properties of symmetric frequency distribution you have to remember that compulsory. What is the property here? X bar is equal to m is equal to mo, that is mean is equal to median is equal to mode. You don't have to write this, I'm just
remembering you, this is the properties of symmetric frequency distribution we already discussed in our first or second session of this chapter. Okay, now what given mode of this data is 84. It is given mode of the symmetric frequency distribution is 84. Now on the basis of this, you can say that therefore in symmetric frequency distribution, mode is equal to median. Therefore, if MO is equal to 84, then median is equal to also 84. So the median, we got that. Now median is equal to 84. Now Q1 is equal to what? First quartile is 68. And you have to find out third quartile. But on the basis of which? On the basis of skewness? On the basis of coefficient of skewness? No. Again, the word symmetric frequency distribution. When the symmetric frequency distribution is there, always skewness is zero. Skewness or its coefficient of skewness always zero in a symmetric frequency distribution. So here you can say again in symmetric frequency distribution, the formula SK is equal to 0 always. Okay, now we have all the values and we just have to find out this. So what is the formula? SK is equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2M. This is the formula. Now SK is equal to what? 0. Q3, we have to find out that. That's why Q3 as it is. Q1, 68 minus 2M, 2 into 84. Okay, so here, therefore, 0, 68, we are transferring it on the opposite side of is equal to. That's why minus 68 plus, minus become plus and plus become minus. Now 2 into 84. 168 is equal to Q3. 0 as it is, this plus is transferred on the opposite side of is equal to, that's why minus. This minus transferring on the opposite side of the is equal to, that's why plus. 2 into 84, 163 is equal to Q3. So here you can say therefore Q3 is equal to 168 minus 68 plus minus minus. And sign of the highest value, so 100. Q3 is equal to 100. So again, you have to remember the theory, that is property of symmetric frequency distribution. These two properties: first, mean median mode is equal always in a symmetric frequency distribution. That's why if mode is equal to 84, then median is also 84. And the second thing, that in the symmetric frequency distribution, skewness is 0, SK is equal to 0. These are the properties of symmetric frequency distribution. Into the sum, you have to use that, because only Q1 is given and Q3 you have to find out. And mode is given. Okay, so you cannot find out by directly from this sum skewness or Q3. Okay, so you have to remember these two properties and then use these two properties and then just find out Q3. Q1 is 68, 2M is equal to, now M is equal to 84. So simplify it and now Q3 is equal to 100. So again, very easy. But you have to remember these two properties for the sum. Now time for homework. Here we complete illustration number up to illustration number 12 and 15, 16. Between these two, 13, 14 illustration is now pending. We will discuss in our next session. But right now the homework is exercise 5.2. Question number 1. And exercise 5, section D. C up to section C we complete. R C leave that. C complete section A B C, because now we understood the Bowley's method. So section A B C you have to complete. We are leaving the lines or pages for this Bowley's method sum. So please now write down all the theories as well as short sums in section A B C for the Bowley's method. So this is your homework. Exercise 5.2 only one sum, and exercise 5 section ABC complete the Bowley's method sums or theories. Okay, so here I am complete my lecture. So thank you class, and we will discuss in our last lecture next session illustration number 13, 14 and so on. Okay, so till that do your homework, and please if you have any doubts ask me, WhatsApp me or join the Zoom lecture. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.